Good morning, student. See, in today's period, what we are going to see, that is the uses of metals. Okay, see, yesterday we have discussed about the comparison between metals and non-metals. Okay, and I told you to write down that all the points in your chemistry notebook. So now we will see our next point, that is uses of metals. See here, I have given some metals, means 7 metals, and what are the uses of that particular metal. Okay, means where it use. So that use we are going to discuss now. Now see, the first metal is gold. Okay, now see, gold, you all know that gold, it is a very common metal. Okay, then where it is used? See, this gold is used to make a jewelry. Do you know that? See, so many jewelries we are wearing for function, so that jewelry is made up of gold. Okay, gold, silver, platinum, so this different metals are used for that. And one more use of gold, that is it is used to fill in a teeth cavity. See, now teeth cavity means what, that you know. Okay, so to fill in a teeth cavity, gold is also used. So this is two common uses of gold. And see here I written the symbol of gold, that is Au. This you already know of, Au means what? Au is a symbol of gold, because in the PDF file I have given you all the metals and what are the symbol of that particular metal. Just go through that notes. Okay, now see here, the second metal is silver. Okay, which is the second metal? Second metal is silver. And see, silver, what is the symbol of silver? Ag. So these same use, these silver is used to make jewelry. And see here picture, it is shown, silver is used to make jewelry as well as it is used to fill in a teeth cavity. Okay, the both are the same uses of gold and silver also. But one more, see, silver is a best conductor of electricity. Do you know this? Silver is a best conductor of electricity. But even though we are not using silver for this electricity, why? Because silver is very costly. So instead of that, we are using a copper. It is a another metal. Okay, but the silver is a best conductor of electricity. Suppose maybe in your exam also the question may ask, which is the best conductor of electricity? And then copper, silver, gold, these all 4 options will be there. In that you have to choose the correct one. Okay, so which is the best conductor of electricity? Silver. Okay, but it is not used for the electrical wiring. Why? Because it is very costly. Now see, third metal is iron. See, iron is a common, so many things, just you observe in your surrounding, so many things is made up of iron. Okay, see, now I am standing here in the classroom, so here grills also made up of iron. Okay, then iron is used to make these benches also. So iron is used to make pipes. Then see here, I have written it is used to make pipe, tanks, cylinders, nails and etc. So many things we can made from this iron. Why? Because iron is a very hard metal. Okay, and it cannot be easily melt. You see, yesterday we have discussed also this point. Okay, iron is very hard metal, so it is used to make tanks, cylinders and cupboard. Okay, this benches, so many things we can made from this iron. Now see, the fourth metal is a copper. See, copper, just now I have discussed, told you that is the copper is used to make this electrical wire and cables. Why? Because it is a less expensive, and because of that we can use these for this electrical wiring. Okay, so this is the one common use, mostly it is used. And one more use, that is we can make utensils, even semi precious ornaments. Means copper is used to make for jewelries also, so it is known as a semi precious, means not a too much expensive. Okay, and semi precious ornament, so it is used for to make utensils as well as for the ornaments and making coins and statues also. See, to make coins and statues, this copper is use in a small amount. Okay, because these coins and statue is made by the alloy. Okay, alloy means what? It is the mixture of one or two or more metals. Okay, so in that copper is they are using copper to make coins and statues. Okay, now see, the next metal is, that metal is a aluminium. Now see, aluminium, just you recall it, where it is used, aluminium. Do you remember? See, aluminium foil. Okay, aluminium foil we use to wrap food items. Okay, so this is also one use of aluminium, as well as to make a utensils, cans. Okay, for cans for drinks, then furniture, for packaging foodstuff and wrappers of medicines, as paint to prevent rust in the form of powder foil. Means this aluminium is used to make utensils, as well as it is used for the packaging foodstuff. Okay, so this is the common use of aluminium. Also, this aluminium is used to prevent rust in the form of powder foil. Okay, means what? The powder foil we are using to prevent a rust. Now rusting, see, iron, you when iron come contact with oxygen, air, okay, it start a rusting, air, oxygen and water, then rust is a form, means that brown color layer is a form. To prevent the from rusty, we use this aluminium powder foil. Okay, this is also another use of aluminium. Now see here, the next metal, that is a zinc. Okay, a zinc is, see, the physical and chemical changes in that the galvanization one process. Galvanization process means what? It used to prevent a rust formation. Okay, so for that also zinc is used. See here, to make dry cells. Now dry cells means what? See, cell which one we are using in batteries. Okay, watch. So that cell is known as a dry cell, and in that zinc is used. Okay, and to coat iron sheets through the process of a galvanization. So you should know about a galvanization. Galvanization means what? It is one a process with zinc coating they are giving to the iron pieces. So for that they can prevent from a rusting. Okay, so this process is known as a galvanization, and for galvanization process we use a zinc powder. Okay, now the next metal is mercury. Which is the next metal? Mercury. Mercury, a common use, you all of you know that mercury is used in a thermometer. Okay, see, mercury is a metal, but in a room temperature it is in a liquid state, and so this mercury is used in a thermometer. So here I written some metals and what are the uses of that metals. See, if you get any information about these metals and the uses, you can add that information in your notebook also. So after this lecture, what you have to do, you just write these all the points. You write these all the points in your chemistry notebook, as well as you read a textbook. If you have ICSE board book, then you just read, collect information and write extra points in your notebook. Okay, see, in metals and non-metals, we just have to do study about the physical properties, the difference between metal and non-metal according to the physical properties, what are the uses of metals and what are the uses of non-metals. These some points only we have to discuss this year. Okay, so today this uses of metals, these some 7 metals uses we completed. So in the next period we will see the uses of non-metals. So now I will stop here. Thank you.